Hare Krishna. See Krishna not just as an object of entertainment, but also as an objective of enlightenment. Many people, when they hear about the stories of Krishna, which nowadays may be depicted in movies, in TV shows, or through comics books, or they may be told by their grandparents or by some storytellers, kathakars, they find out these stories so attractive. And when people watch such TV shows where Krishna Leela is being depicted, they often see Krishna as an object of entertainment. There might be Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman, and like that there is Krishna. So now, any way of approaching Krishna, of connecting with Krishna is good, because there is at least the beginning of Krishna consciousness thereby. Krishna is entering into people's consciousness. However, if we see Krishna only as an object of entertainment, then we miss out on the blessings that Krishna can offer us. Krishna is also the objective of enlightenment. He is the person whom we are always searching for. He is the all-attractive, all-loving person. Everything attractive everywhere manifests simply a spark of Krishna's splendor. And if we just understand this, if we just connect with Him in a mood of loving devotion, then He can free us from all illusion and He can take us toward the supreme enlightenment. And this, seeing the activities of Krishna not just as entertainment but as enlightenment, is stressed in the Bhagavad-Gita 4.9, where Krishna says, Yo janma karma chame divyam evam yo vetti tatvataha tyaktva deham punarjanma naiti mameti so Arjuna. So He says, janma karma chame divyam. My appearance and activities, if one understands them to be divine, to be transcendental. And how does one understand them? Tattvataha, as in truth, with philosophical clarity. Then, what will happen to them? Tyaktva deham. When eventually they will leave their body, punarjanma naiti, they won't take birth again. Mameti so Arjuna, they will attain me. So Krishna is the supreme object of supreme purpose of life. Attaining love for Him, attaining eternal absorption in Him, is the ultimate state of enlightenment. This Krishna talks about in 15.19 in the Bhagavad Gita, Yo mameva asammudho janati purushottamam sa sarvavid bhajati mam sarvabhavena bharata. So He says, Yo mameva asammudho, one without delusion understands, janati purushottamam, that Krishna is the supreme person, the all attractive person. Sa sarvaved, that person has become all knowing. The essence of all knowledge is them. That person is enlightened. And what happens to such an enlightened person? Bhajati mam, they devote themselves to me. Sarva bhavena bharata, with all the emotion of the heart. So when we treat Krishna as an object of entertainment, we might put some emotion in Him and some emotion in someone else, some other character, entertainment character. But we devote ourselves to Krishna, understanding Him the objective of enlightenment, then all our emotion gets invested in Him. And He reciprocates by flooding our hearts with unlimited ecstatic spiritual emotions. Thank you. Hare Krishna.